As long as America has been dominated by Anglo-Saxon traditions, beer has been a predominant part of American culture. In the 1840s, the first lagers were brewed in America. Not too long after, the Germans brought over what we know today as the Pilsner beer. Unfortunately, in 1919, Prohibition denied the sale of alcohol, but thankfully was repealed in 1933. However, from the 1960s to the 1980s, there was a decline in microbreweries. But the 1990s and so on would see a burst of entrepreneurial brewers, such as one located in the middle of Pennsylvania known as Otto's Pub and Brewery.
Drove by a few times, tried and tried to get in. It's hard to get in here.
I think they have the best beer that I've had at any microbrew pub. I've been to many across the country, different states, and this Blackmo Stout is definitely the best stout I've ever had. And the quality of the beer has just been fabulous. It's been great. Everything else is just a bonus to that.
Otto is my cat. He's, he's kind of our mascot, I guess. The idea started when I worked at the Bullfrog Brewery. I was a co-owner there, and I had had the idea of I really wanted to branch off and to get into the State College area. So right around 2001, I left the Bullfrog, and it took us about a year of construction. We had to open in October of 2002. A partner and I started up Otto's. Like I said, we've been open since then. We sell to accounts in Center County and in Clinton County right now, and Lycoming County. We are going to venture into bottling probably in the spring, and we're going to start selling six packs and cases, and that'll probably expand our distribution from there. I think the big thing that we do well is that we play around a lot, whereas, you know, the big breweries are pretty much stuck with what they make, you know, their basic handful of styles, and it's pretty close. I mean, there really isn't a whole lot of difference between Coors Light and regular Coors when you really get down to it. And then, you know, with us, it's like we have a huge variety of styles. And I think people embrace that. And I think that's one of the big advantages we have over big breweries is the our mobility, you know, and our ability to just go, you know, well, today I'm going to try this, and tomorrow I'm going to try this.
First and foremost, I mean, it's fresh beer. I mean, it's made right here on the premises, so it's not something that's made somewhere else and put into a keg and shipped across the country or anything else.
A day of brewing a beer involves several steps in the process. First, we start by we get our all of our grain together for a certain recipe. Mill the grain. After it's done milling, it goes through the auger. Auger goes into what's called the mash tun. The mashing occurs. We then strain out all that sugar out by basically rinsing water over top of the mash bed. And we collect all that sugary liquor into the kettle. And we boil for about an hour and 20 minutes. During that boil, we add the hops. The hops are the flavor, bitter element of beer. Then we'll chill the whole mixture down through a heat exchanger down into anywhere from 55 to 68 degrees, depending on ale or lager. The ales we will chill down to about 65 degrees and we'll ferment usually at 68. We pump them over into a fermenter. We'll then add our yeast to the fermenter. And usually in about 3 to 5 days for the ales, about 5 to 8 days for the lagers, fermentation will occur. After fermentation is complete, then we'll drain off the spent yeast that is done. After it's done fermenting, it settles to the bottom. We'll chill the tanks down to about 36 degrees. We usually age them for about a month after it's been chilled down. We'll filter the beers into a bright tank, carbonate the beers, and either keg them off or we'll serve them directly out of the serving tanks to the bar. Our most sold beer is probably close between the Helles and the Red Mill. The two of those sell pretty well. In the summer, sometimes the Apricot Wheat's the biggest seller. I probably have about 50 others that I brew, you know, randomly throughout the year.
Winter, I like the porters and the stouts the best. Summer, I usually go for something lighter. I like the red Moe a lot.
She had the apricot. I had the black Moe and a couple others. Tried them. Very good. Yeah, it's got nice taste. Nice taste.
I think people are intrigued by the beer, and people like the beers that we brew here. And I think the food probably brings people back. It certainly is. We try to mix up some really interesting varieties of beer, along with like the food. You know, we try to mix up some interesting specials and whatnot too. So.
Yeah, burgers are great. Wings, very good.
I enjoy making new recipes because every beer I do here is my own recipe. So I enjoy coming up with new things, you know, creating new things by combining different ingredients. That's kind of fun. Like any chef would with a dish. That certainly is probably one of the big thrills. And plus, it's neat to go out, you know, to another establishment and see your beer on tap. That's kind of a thrill.
Another reason I love to come to Otto's, I've been here since they opened the place, because I'm Pub Club number 2, and the people are absolutely fabulous. The staff that's been here from the beginning, Jill and Angela especially, and Mike and Charlie the Brewmeister, absolutely fabulous people. So that's another reason I keep coming back.
Drink, 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 blue eyes that are bright as stars when they're shining on me. Drink, drink.